Hello everyone, welcome to MATLAB Simulink Essentials. In this video, we will see the simulation for solar inverter. So for that, we will be using different components. So first of all, we will create a solar panel subsystem. Then we will connect this boost converter to the subsystem. And afterwards, we will give this connections of this boost converter to the single phase inverter. So we will be dealing with several components which are present in the library browser. And along with that, we will see how to use this solar cell and how to create a subsystem in Simulink. So now let us start with solar cell. So take the solar cell. So here, if you will observe, the solar cell is having three terminals. The first one is irradiance, the second one is the positive terminal, and the third is negative terminal. Now open this block. So here you will find the short circuit current rating as 7.34 ampere. Output voltage, open circuit voltage is 0.6 volt and irradiance used here is 1000 watt per meter square. So we will keep these values as it is. Here we will design the solar panel which will give us the output voltage of 9 volts. So for that we need to connect 15 solar cells in series with each other. So copy this block. And do the connections here. Connect all these solar cells in series with each other. Now to this irradiance terminal, we will connect one constant block. So as the irradiance selected is 1000, so we will give here the constant value of this constant block as 1000 and connect this block to this irradiance. So if you will see here, we are not able to connect this constant block to this irradiance terminal of the solar cell. Because this solar cell is a physical system block and this constant block is a Simulink block. So for that we will need Simulink to PS converter, which is Simulink to physical system converter. So let's have it. And now let us try to connect this. So if you will see, we are able to connect this constant block with the help of this Simulink to PS converter to this solar cell. Now connect the irradiance terminals of the remaining block to this constant block. Now copy these 5 solar cells, press on Ctrl and paste it. Make one more copy of this block and now connect them here, this negative terminal to this positive terminal and this irradiance terminal to this constant block. Connect this negative to the positive terminal of the solar cell. Now take one voltage sensor block. And connect this positive terminal to this first solar cell positive terminal and negative to here. Let us take the display block so as to view the output voltage. Now connect this output of this voltage sensor to this display block. So if you will observe here, the connection is not taking place because this is the physical system block and this display block is present in our Simulink library. So for that we will need PS converter. PS to Simulink converter. So if you will open it, here you will find that this block will convert input, which is physical signal, into the Simulink signal output. Now take solver configuration. So this block is required for simulation of these components, and you can connect it anywhere. Take one electrical reference. Let us take this stop time as 2 seconds and save the file. Now run our simulation. Now as you can observe here, we are getting the output voltage as 9 volt, because open circuit voltage of each solar cell is 0.6 volt, and we have connected such 15 solar cells in series with each other. Now take control voltage source. This is the signal terminal of this controlled voltage source, and connect this to the output of the solar cell. Now take out the two connections from this controlled voltage source, and we will now convert this entire solar panel into one subsystem. So control plus A so as to select all the components. Right click on any of the component, you will get an option to create a subsystem from the selection. So here we have connected one subsystem, and if you will open this, our subsystem of solar panel is present here. So let us rename this subsystem as solar panel. Now this is like a DC voltage source, and the output of this DC voltage source is 9 volts. Now we will use a boost converter, which will increase our voltage. So for that, take series RLC branch present in the specialized power system library. Convert this branch type to inductive, and we will choose this default values. Take the MOSFET present in the specialized power system library. Remove this measurement port as it is not required. Take one pulse generator block. Open it. So this period we will write this in terms of switching frequency as 1 divided by 1000 Hertz. We will keep this switch on for 50% of the time. Connect this pulse generator to this gate terminal of this MOSFET. Take the diode present in the specialized power system library and remove the measurement port of this diode as well. Copy this block and convert it into capacitive branch. Now at the output of this boost converter, we will get a boosted voltage, and now let us connect this boosted voltage to single phase bridge inverter. So for that, take the MOSFET. Remove this measurement port. Let us rename this block as switch 1, S1. And now configure the bridge configuration. Connect this drain terminals of this S1 and S3 together. And source terminal of this S2 S4 together. Connect the output of this boost converter so to take out this connection, just click on this and right click and drag it, so you will get here the connection. So we will take here the capacitor value as 100 microfarads. Copy this block and convert this branch type to resistive. Let us consider the resistance of 100 ohms and connect it to this bridge inverter. Take the voltage measurement block. Connect it across the load side. Take the scope so as to view the waveforms. Copy this voltage measurement here as well. Measure the output of this boost converter. Just rename this as input to this inverter. Change here the number of input ports and the display of the scope block. Let us rename this as output of this inverter. Now take pulse generator block. Open this block, change here this period to 20 milliseconds, so we can write this period as 1 divided by 50 hertz as well. So this switch S1 will conduct for 50% of the time without any phase delay. Connect this to switch S, gate terminal of switch S1, copy this block and connect it to the gate terminal of the second switch. So this switch also will conduct for 50% of the time. Now copy this block, open it, and now this switch S3 and S4 will conduct at the phase delay of 10 milliseconds for 50% of the time. So for this switch S3 also, we will apply the phase delay of 10 milliseconds. Take the power guide block. So this block is required for the simulation of these components. Now save the changes. And run our simulation. So here the solar panel is giving us the output of 9 volts. To this solar panel we have connected one boost converter, and further this boost converter has been connected to the single phase bridge inverter. So let us check this output voltage waveforms. So as you can observe here, the output of this boost converter, which we have given the input as to the single phase inverter is almost 35 volts, and output of this single phase inverter is varying from plus 35 volts to minus 35 volts. So that's all from this video. Check out the description box for the quiz and do answer them in the comment section. Thank you for watching this video. Like, share and subscribe to the channel Start Scratch, and do check out our other videos to learn similar skills through our bite-sized content.